is it over? Because the potential liability for that is just enormous. So. Yeah.
So, and then was it your, you said you went, after high school, you hitchhiked through Europe and Africa.
Right.
Looking in search of what? Meaning?
Yeah, meaning. It was a whole kind of on the road sort of thing.
Yeah.
And I mean, Ohio was, at that time, a really boring place, and I needed to get out and see the world.
Ooh, that's a big one.
Well, they actually have like really good cheese at Whole Foods, and it is a lot better actually. Let's not.
And so going through Europe and Africa, and you came upon just cultural artifacts that impressed you. Was that what happened?
I still was always trying to be. To survive and be self-employed. I mean, I made metal rings and sold them to tourists. I made candles in Denmark and sat in the subway hawking them. I mean, I tried everything that I could possibly do.
Yeah.
So,
did you research some of this? Was there a need for candles in the subway in Denmark? I mean, did you?
It was more of what was simple and what could I do in a tiny apartment, and that was kind of what led to my product selection.
Yeah.
It was really basic. It wasn't until I came back to the U.S. that I got into the really good stuff, like the rubber chicken business.
Yeah. There's a picture here of you dressed up as a Viking, I believe. The Viking helmet and horns and selling hand-knitted sweaters.
I'm not worried about the vehicle that it's stuck. I'm just worried about the clearance.
I was paid $3 an hour to look like a Viking and tell people to go up the street to this sweater market.
Okay, same that was yours.
No. It was a great job, but I had to stand all day, and eventually I started sitting down on the job and I was fired. It was painful.
Oh, Jesus.
It was the best thing that could have happened.
Yeah.
So then you were collecting stamps, and then you were collecting old toys, and you're a collector.
Yes.
Do you want me to roll up your window?
I loved the stuff in the back of comic books, the X-ray specs, and the squirrel monkeys, and all that stuff,
And what was that catalog you used to get when kids got the novelties and the X-ray vision glasses and stuff?
Johnson Smith in Michigan?
Yeah, it's the same thing. The hand buzzers and stuff. But you've gone really beyond that. How did you happen to set up this Archie McPhee thing? Which was with your great uncle or something like that?
Well, my wife's great uncle. I took that name just because it was such a snappy, easy to say and spell sort of name.
Yeah.
And, it was just a good name, and it was at the time when companies like L.L. Bean and Eddie Bauer were really powerful.
All right, we're in the clear.
All the marketing people that I read said that you should use a person's name because it'll really connect with people.
You're taking
that was, and I never met him, although I met his widow, Beth, who came to see us. She's from North Dakota, and she just wept when she saw, you know, what I was doing. I'd asked her permission to take the name, and she saw all the novelties and toys and said how much she would have loved it. It was very touching.
Yeah. And then, so when you started, what were some of your first items that you mentioned? Was it the walking, chattering teeth, or the ant watch, or?
Well, a lot of those classic things I bought from others and resold in the beginning, and then we started making things like, you know, I had all these plastic ants, and then I had all these watches that didn't sell, so, you know, we started taking apart the watches and putting the ants inside the watches. I mean, it was a constant, any sort of action to change something to try to make it more interesting and sellable. That's what we did.
And originally people would bring you things too, right, that were sort of strange carloads of things that nobody wanted, objects.
Yes, that's wonderful, and that still happens to this day. It's quite interesting to see what people have in garages and basements. And,
the Japanese fuzzy mechanical bartenders, that was one of those situations?
That was when I would deliver cars from New York to L.A. through Drive-Away, and I would stop in drugstores in the Midwest, Kansas, Nebraska, and I would find these old Japanese toys covered with dust on the shelves in these stores. And I would just buy them all and fill up the car with these old toys. And then I knew dealers in each city that just, you know, took everything I could come up with.
Mm-hmm. So you started networking and people took you around and came to a place and... Like those propaganda posters you found in Kansas in the barn?
Yeah, that's...
This is all part of Laguna Madre here, you think?
They're still
on the right, too?
And I look at them and I said, boy, I need to do something with those.
Yeah, you still got them.
I do. I pretty much have every state.
This could have been a serious problem instead of a career, right? This could be just a hoarding.
Well, it's a little bit of a hoarding thing, actually.
But these posters, what it says on when you drive alone, you drive with Hitler from World War II, right?
Mm-hmm.
About cars.
It was all real stuff. Yeah. It's fascinating.
Yeah. Amazing. But at a certain point, though, these things weren't around anymore. You bought up all you could find, and you had to start making your own.
Right. I searched for old things, and that got to be extremely exhausting because, you know, after you sold them, you didn't have anything left. And I teamed up with an importer who was retiring, who took me to Asia and introduced me to his contacts and basically explained and held my hand on the importing trade. And we started designing our own things, often things that we couldn't get anymore. We would improve them and we would design them and we would have them made. And that's been the way it's been for decades now, to just think it up, design it, manufacture it, sell it, and then see what's next.
Yeah, so this is a breakthrough because this is like in the 80s in China, and probably no one else was doing what you were doing. These manufacturers to work with you.
Well, there were plenty of people trying to do all kinds of things, but what I was doing was really odd. And it was kind of a swashbuckling time. I mean, I can still remember going to like a city called Shenzhen and seeing ox carts on a dirt street down the middle of it. And that city now has, I think, 12 million people. I mean, the growth has been breathtaking there.
Do you still go there and work with your Chinese suppliers?
Yes, every year. I really enjoy that. A lot of them, I'm working with the sons of the owners who have retired or passed away.
What were some of your first ideas that came through the Chinese connection?
Oh, this is where the mind goes blank, yeah. Because I've done thousands and thousands of things. In the beginning, I didn't have the money to do a lot of the tooling, which is expensive. And one thing that I found were these punching puppets. And we decided we were doing religious things heavy, and we decided to make a nun habit and put it on this hand puppet that had little levers inside with punching
nuns?
Boxing gloves.
The boxing nuns. I gave that to someone, a Catholic friend, I might add, yes.
Well, I'll give you a really deep, dark secret about that.
Yeah.
The head on that is Margaret Thatcher.
And you modified it to make it a bunch of money.
Well, we just put the habit on it, but I was sitting in the office, and the guy, it was a company that kind of did a lot of political punchers, and they did like Khrushchev and European politicians and Nixon and that sort of thing. And I, you know, I needed just a basic woman, and I saw the head of Thatcher. And I realized that if I just put a hat over that and didn't connect it, nobody would know that it was Thatcher. And it was really amusing when the product really took off that was the Iron Lady underneath that nun's habit.
Is that where the rubber chicken came to be too? Is it? Was yours the first of the rubber chickens? I know they had it in Bonneville, didn't they? The chicken.
No, it's been around for many years, and you know, a lot of the things I did, it was